During Grade 7, let's talk about what you are going to learn during this week. First of all, we are going to shift Lesson 5 in Topic 8 to this week. It's going to be about solving questions involving circumference of a circle. When you are dealing with the circles, we have to know the radius and the diameter. Of course, we are going to learn more about pi, which is the relation between the circumference of any circle to its diameter. You are going to learn the relation between them. Of course, you will learn two relations. The first one, the circumference is equal to pi times d. D is the diameter. As long as the diameter equals to 2r, so we can replace this by another relation, which is c equals pi 2r, or c equals 2 by r. We will solve questions related to that. You are going to see real world or real life questions that relate this concept to the reality. For example, here you have this wheel, here you have the gears. They are all circles, so you can use the circumference rules in order to solve them. The key concept, the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its diameter is pi. It is approximately, not exactly, 3.14 or 22 over 7. Again, this is the radius, which is half the diameter. As always, we are going to take questions as homeworks, and we will solve them together at class. Next, we will start 8-6, which is solve problems involving area of a circle. So we still talking about the circles, but now we want to find the area, not the perimeter or the circumference. To find the area, of course, there is a relation, which is the area of a circle equals what? Pi r squared. Okay, we will use this relation. Okay. We'll try to use this relation in real world situations, as you can see here, and you are going to practice. Again, the equations are related to the reality, world problems, and then you are going to use the relations in order to find the areas. This is the key concept. It says that the area equals pi r squared. Okay, again, we are going to practice at class. Also, you are going to have homeworks and we will solve them together. They are vary from simple questions to another questions that need more than one step in order to solve them. Again, the LMS is full of resources. You can find videos. You can find interactive activities. You can find worksheets and their answers. And one challenging question. You can find that in all the days. Hope you are going to enjoy it and try to practice on that. Good luck, Grade 7. See you. Bye-bye.